I always bear in mind the story that I'm telling, and for me to succeed in telling a convincing story, I need to care about the characters.
Being able to interpret a character is the foundation of having a successful and convincing reenactment.
I always let the audience feel the vibe of the character once I'm in front of the camera. Once I get enmeshed in my character, I'm consumed.
A story drives the emotions of the audience. Getting the audience to feel the character in question is key.
To me, producing a movie of this nature is not just challenging, but inspiring.
Apo is a delicate Igbo concept that is most often than not misconceived.
The concept is deep, but yet simple enough to comprehend.
African science fiction, it's not new. We've always had it.
Chike is the central character in our story. He is an apt metaphor of the common man that believes in the impossible.
Millions of stories have been told about love.
Some of the good ones, some of the bad ones.
But how you tell your love story makes the difference.
Love is multidimensional. You can't exhaust all it has to offer.
Nkonye, as the name suggests, is a question that is posed to people who fall in love with the wrong person. She is a symbol of a quenched passion. She's that part of us that refuses to tell the truth.
Nyasha is half Nigerian and half Zimbabwean. She represents the remnant of what remains in Africa after the coming of the white man.
Wanyi Buife is a character that is living her nightmare.
Time travel has been a concept made popular by writers. The belief that the three concepts of time, that is past, present and future, exist side by side, has given birth to a lot of theories.
Coming down to our environment, giving our science a face with this concept is what makes this movie project unique.
I fell in love with the project and with the character Nyasha. She's intriguing, vast, in-depth, bold, elegant and fearless. She's the normalization of African science. She is the exposure of the truth hidden beneath the slave trade agenda, which is yet one among the numerous ways Africa was robbed.
The character Nkonye resonated with me, not because of who she is, but because of her completeness as a character. The reversal in what she did challenges me because it's a complete opposite of who I am in real life.
Relating to this project, Agu is not an epic movie or a movie filled with jazz, ritual or diabolism.
People misconceive the African tradition by saying it's fetish.
That's because they are used often for bad intentions.
This story strives to show that most of what we see as diabolism are indeed science.
Producing this film for Geographic's TV channel and Dust YouTube channel is a welcome development.
It's better experienced than told.
African science fiction, you don't want to miss this.
After watching this, you'll be proud of your blackness.